Michael's gonna show us how to clean his ear. First, we need a what?
Q-tip.
All right.
Put water on it. You just...
Come closer.
You just put this right here.
And so you got a little water, so you wet it. Why did you wet it?
Because that's how you get the earwax. That attracts the earwax to the Q-tip.
Oh,
okay,
yeah. It's like that. Bait.
Yeah.
I agree. It kind of wets it a little bit and makes it... It does. Oh, okay. Boom. It attracts. That is a nice word. Keep going. What are we doing?
So you start at the top.
Uh-huh.
And you go down. Go this way. Repeat.
Uh-huh.
And you go right here.
Are you feeling for anything or are you just rubbing? Because I think there should be a feeling.
Well, God, I think he's doing something.
Yeah, he's definitely doing something.
That's gross.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry, I didn't mean
so
to say
So don't
that.
Try
that
to get on your
natural,
face or something.
It's beautiful.
So you put it, you do this.
Mm-hmm. You don't need to rub a place too much. And then when your Q-tip looks like that, flip turn it to the other side.
This?
Yeah, that's gross. And all you're doing is just pushing dirt back and forth, back and forth.
And
so use the clean side. And you're feeling, remember like the square when I said you got to cover the whole surface? You don't just do part of it. You got to cover the whole surface of your ear. So every part. So don't just wipe one part over and over again. Yep. And get into the crease. Good job.
Yes. The last French fry.
That's the reaction, huh?
Mm-hmm.
How come you didn't offer it to me?
So put my hand up.
Because I didn't put my hand up?
No. Wait, you shouldn't have got before I did.
Oh, so it was a matter of who reached for it first?
Yes.
Okay.
Next time.
Next time?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not sure you're writing in your purse, right?
But you guys go make us some more fries. And all will be forgiven. Don't we need some more fries in our life?
Huh?
Don't we need some more fries in our life?
Yes, we need 1 billion fries. We need infinite fries.
I'm saying infinite. Come through vocabulary.
Healthy fries. I mean, put them in the air fryer. All of them. And we have infinite.
All right, save our ketchup. We can use that again.
Thank you.
Hook it up.
I used the whole bags.
You already used the whole bag?
No, I said I'm going to use the whole bag.
All right.
Entraron Ryan y Balvin. El hace calor. Reggaeton pide la nena. Este party se jodió, estoy repartiendo candela.
La baby pide el alcohol, pa' activar todos los poderes. En el piso llueve sudor, aquí hay niveles de niveles.
Yo trolando en el club, baby cambia ese mood. El ghetto es el negocio, no importa qué pienses tú. La calle en control, desde Spotify, YouTube. Estoy aprobado por Yankee, por eso sobra la pasta. Nadie sabe cuánto se gasta. Perro de raza, perro de casta. Las babies son pupis, pero fuman como rasta. Siempre original gangsta.
Ven, bajemos esta bellaquera. Hago un call y la disco me la cera. Los demás que se vayan pa' afuera. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Ey, abo.
Solo queda mi combo y tus amigas pa'l sistema.
Y'all listen to these boys, listen to the song they're singing. Look at how he's studying his big brother.
This is why you have kids close together. Don't spread them out. They need... That's not true. My 19-year-old is my 7-year-old and 5-year-old's best friend, so spacing out isn't the factor. It's the effort. Yes, they are closer to their siblings that live in the home than their sibling that lives outside of the home, because it takes more effort to build that relationship. But this isn't effort versus effort. This is, you have them close in age so they can be each other's best friend. And they actually learn, not through theory, but through practical application, because they have a built-in playmate. But just because there's years, decades between you and your siblings, doesn't mean that you can't be close. It just takes more effort. But just watching those two together really, really warmed my soul and warmed my heart. And these are the moments we must stop taking for granted. They out there singing, "Nobody loves me like you." No, I think they were singing their own version. I might have heard some boo-boo and some doo-doo and some other stuff, but they definitely had the cadence. They're starting to sing worldly songs. It's funny, they're starting to develop their ears, so it's funny to hear the songs that they just bust out singing, what's playing in their head from their environment.